Hey.
Hi. What you got there?
Truth. I give up.
You looking for some company?
Well, it's been all about Alan around here. I thought maybe we could have some Harley and Gus time. But I am trying.
Well, it's not going to be much longer, I promise you, I promise. Did you see him out there? It's my father, looking up at the stars. The whole thing is so surreal to me, you know?
Oh, he can have all the stars he wants, if I can have you all to myself.
May the late, great Alan Spaulding rest in peace. Knowing that the company and the family is in your hands. And since Alan's not here, I will teach you everything you need to know about being a Spaulding.
What? You will never replace me, Alexandra. Never!
I'm alive and coming to get you. Yeah, it's true. Oh. Oh. Oh, you. You are out there, Alan. The drug's wearing off. And you know something. You know something.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were talking to someone.
Nolan.
Yeah.
I need to know who delivered this note to me.
I don't really know. They just slipped it under the door, and it's not bad news, is it?
No. No, it's fine. Everything's just fine. But I need to get some rest. So you make sure that the house is all locked down tight, and I won't be taking any phone calls.
All right, very good.
Excuse me, sir. We're upgrading you to a much nicer room, the presidential suite. You can have a drink on us while you're waiting.
Scheduled to perform.
Well, Tammy, there's a perfectly good explanation for all of this. The champagne arrived for the party. Your mother and I argued over the virtues of domestic bubbly. We had a few glasses and she won.
Doesn't look to me like she won.
Well, that wasn't the prize, Tammy. It was a refresher course on the waltz.
Mom's a great dancer. Dad taught her how to dance. She doesn't need you for that.
All right, you see right through me. Neither of us danced for a long time. We never danced together, so.
RJ and Will are fast asleep. Can I have the car to visit Lizzie?
Visit Lizzie? Tammy, it's awfully late.
Lizzie just found out that her grandfather's disappeared, and she's upset. I'm not really needed around here.
Be home by 11.
11:30?
11. And be careful.
Okay. You too.
Thanks for telling her that nothing was going on.
Nothing was going on. It was a dance, just a dance.
That's not true. Something happened between us, Edmund, and you know it, and I know it.
Thank you.
okay? What are you doing?
I'm dropping off a care package. My parents are convinced that Mara's moving across the country and not just across town.
Yeah, well, she's out with Tony. She said I could borrow something to wear for the gala.
Oh, so that's what you're doing here. So where's my friend Ben?
He's working late, as usual.
His loss. You know, we need to talk.
Jane, turn around. You know, maybe we shouldn't.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah, I know, but, you know, people need to talk, and then they actually talk, and then nothing's ever the same again. And I don't want to lose you, Jane Lewis.
It's not going to happen.
You know, I'm with Ben.
Yeah, you don't need to remind me.
Yeah, but when you walked in here just now, it was...
Look, I'm your friend, okay? But I'm also a guy, you know, and objectively speaking,
okay, but
you're not...
You know, just listen. I mean, was that thing even really a kiss, you know?
No, we were both just caught up in the excitement of the moment.
Oh, I know, that's what it was. It's the excitement in the moment. It's the adrenaline rush. I was just... I mean, it's not every day that a scout comes and discovers you. I was just so happy for you.
Right.
I mean, I was, you know? It was weird. I almost felt as if you were, like... discovering me or something too is weird as that sounds. And so I guess when we, you know, it just didn't mean anything other than I was really happy for you.
Okay.
Okay. So are we okay?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, good. You know, you need to remember. When that scout actually signs you, we need to be a little more careful as to exactly how it is we express our excitement.
If you say so.
Oh, you can turn around now. What do you think? Yeah, I don't know. My dad would probably flip. He still thinks I'm 12. Come on, what do you think? Objectively speaking, of course.
You don't look 12 to me.
Alan, that is not Alexander, it's Harley. Look at her. Look at her. That's Harley.
I've never been so happy in my life to see you, Harley.
Well, that's a first.
Sit down, sit down, sit down.
Yeah, sit down.
I don't know what happened. I thought the worst was over. I thought the drugs were all out of his system.
You know what? This might not be such a bad thing.
Why? What do you mean?
We didn't have any proof that Alexander was drugging him. Now maybe we do.
What do you mean? We run a blood test. We take a blood sample.
Yes.
We do a tox screen.
No needles and no hospital.
No, it's all right. No, he's right. We're not going to take him to Cedars. I mean, everybody's looking from half the force, half the town. We have to keep Alexandra and Philip in the dark till we prove what she's done to him. Then what?
We don't have to go anywhere. We have a new neighbor, the transferred RN. And she doesn't know Alan from Adam.
Okay, so we get a blood sample, but then how do we run the test?
I've got somebody in mind. Let me just make a call.
You have any idea how much you owe that lady?
Believe me, Gus, I always repay my debts. Just ask Alexandra.
Come on in. You want to climb in here with me? Do you have a bad dream or something?
Next, you want to read me a bedtime story.
Oh.
Besides, if anyone's scared, it's you. Grandpa isn't on a business trip, is he?
No, he isn't, darling.
In fact, the only trip he's on is in his head, right?
Who told you about Alan, Lizzie?
How could you all keep this from me?
Don't be angry at us for, you know, trying to protect you. You know, that's just our misguided love.
I don't need that kind of love. I'm sorry, Aunt Alex. It wasn't your place to tell me. It was Mom and Dad's. He's your brother. You must want him home safe and sound more than anyone.
Absolutely, absolutely. He is in my every single waking thought, dear. Which is exactly why I need to get some sleep.
Good night.
Yeah, good night, sweetheart. And Lizzie. Lizzie, don't be too harsh on your parents. I mean, after all, their hearts were in the right spot.
I'll give it my best shot. See you in the morning.
Played hide and seek in a long time, have we? So long you've probably forgotten that I always win. Remember?
You! Good luck! Handmade shirt, German Street. Oh, for... Oh, this is... You...
Excuse me.
No! What? Nolan! Will you stop creeping around like that?
I'm sorry. You all right?
Just tell me something. Are these Allen shoes?
I believe they are, ma'am.
They are Allen shoes. Well, how did they get in here? I mean, these shoes just don't walk in here. Never mind. Never mind. Would you please just get them out of here?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Why do you sound so surprised, Olivia? Why wouldn't I want a new dress? Well, Aunt Alex reminded me how important it is for us to stick together right now. I mean, you are my ex-step grandmother and future whatever. So I'll see you in the morning.
And the award for best actress in a family drama goes to...
She really thinks she can win me over by some shopping trip. Please.
It could be fun.
Oh, yeah, it'll be a great time. So, what are you up to? I mean, it's kind of late for you to be driving around.
I wanted to apologize for not telling you about your grandfather.
It was my parents' place to tell me. But they're liars. That's what they do. They call it protection, but they just don't want to deal.
With what?
With me. Idea, let's go see Mara's new place.
Now?
She's your cousin. You can stop by whenever you want, right?
I have a curfew.
Please, just for a little bit.
Okay. Hey. I know there's a lot of crazy stuff going on with your family right now, but just for the record, parents don't always lie.
Whatever you say.
I owe you an apology.
Why?
Because I used you. We were on the dance floor. I didn't see you as Edmund Winslow and all the baggage that comes with you, you know? You were just a man.
And any man would have done?
In that moment, yes. That really sounds...
awful. But it's very human. And as you said, Cassie, it takes two to tango. And if we had kissed in that moment, well, I don't think it would have been the end of the world.
It wouldn't?
No. And if I've given you a few moments of distraction, happiness, I'm glad. And I have to tell you, I think I like the idea that you are seeing me as just a man, forgetting all the awful things I've done to you, if even only for a song.
You're a very good dancer.
So are you. Think you can squeeze me on your dance card tomorrow night?
I think I can.
It's bad time.
Yes, it is. I need you to come over here right away.
Tomorrow.
Tonight. You're the only one I can trust.
All right, I'll be right there. I have to go. Benefactor for the library. She wants to increase her donation. Or at least she will when I'm finished with her.
It's great. Go. Edmund?
Nothing. See you later.
Wait. Thanks for understanding all that.
It's just a dance.
Mrs. Winslow, shall I take the champagne out onto the terrace? Mrs. Winslow?
Sorry. It's one of my husband's favorite songs, so...
Is ready, sir.
It's not every day we get an orchestra here. It sounds pretty good, though, huh?
I'm gonna do the receipts down here, so if you could bring them to me, that would be great. I'm gonna hang out till Tammy gets back.
Can you believe this place? No parents around. This is
more than cool.
You can just leave a place like that?
Boarding school is nothing like that. There were rules, and you didn't get to choose who you had to live with. This is freedom.
You need to work on your pickup move.
Look at you guys. Tammy, what are you doing? Lindsay, what are you doing here? When'd you get back?
Huh? I've been around. In fact, I saw you at company this morning.
Why didn't you say hi?
Let's just say you were a little preoccupied. You're the one who didn't hit the stupid ball. Hey! Lizzie, hey! Whoa, I can't believe you're back here. School out in Connecticut or what? Oh, well, there was a fire. Actually, Lizzie's lucky to be alive.
I'm glad you're okay.
I'm better and I'm back. And I want to know what I missed out on. So, how long have you two been playing catch?
Oh, I was just helping him with his pitching motion. Just, you know, helping him out as a friend.
Well, with a dress like that, it's hard to miss.
Great target.
Also a fabulous dress.
Thank you. You know, Mara has a ton of them. Go throw one on. You can help me beat Shane.
I can't. You know, my mom's...
Oh, yeah. Don't say anything else. I understand the countdown to curfew. Oh, you know, if it'll help you out, I could give Lizzie a ride home later and give us a chance to catch up. My car's out front.
The convertible's yours?
I know, right? Isn't it great? Ben gave it to me.
He got you a car?
Yeah.
You guys are serious.
You have no idea. Oh, and just so we all know this, the whole car thing is extremely on the DL.
I don't think anybody uses that anymore.
No, seriously, because I think my dad thinks the only set of wheels I need right now are training wheels, and he's not exactly the biggest fan of Ben, so, you know, until that changes or I turn 18, I'm keeping the car strictly out of his sight line.
Well, your secret is safe with me. I wouldn't want to get anyone in any trouble.
You got some serious explaining to do, young lady.
I was kind of hoping we could meet down in the study.
What?
I am
I'm not trying to seduce you, you idiot.
Read this.
At least we know your brother's still alive.
Alive and well and kicking and hell-bent on terrifying me. Edmund, I want you to help me stop this. Just stop the whole thing. You owe me.
Consider my silence through this whole ordeal, payment in full.
Come on, you're not going to abandon me now. Please.
Miss Andrea, you helped me when I was down. Oh. And I'm never going to forget that. And now the shoe's on the other foot. So if you need my help, you've got it.
You are a prince.
Yes, I am. For a price.
You're putting me in a really lousy position, Harley. Really lousy. I can't start doing favors.
Favors? I gave birth to your son. Do you forget what's involved in labor?
Please, I can still hear the echo of your screaming. I was there, remember?
Well, you weren't the one who
was
actually...
What's this all about?
Rick, I have to prove that a witness was poisoned.
This is a very big favor, Harley. I hope this is important.
I know. I know. Are you in or out?
All right. I'll drop her off the lab on the way to the beacon. You owe me.
I know. Thank you. You can come out.
Yeah. Good. Good work. Good work. Once we have proof that Alexander drugged me, we will seal my sister's fate. I know that you and I have had our differences in the past. We've fought a lot. But this is the fight of my life, Harley. And you will never know how much you have helped me through this. Gus, once we have proof, we go to the next step. We have to find the source of that drug by any means necessary.
Okay, I can explain. You're just gonna have to give me a minute here.
Why, so you can come up with an excuse? The evidence is right in front of my face.
Daddy, you're the chief of police. You're not...
What, the boss of you? Actually, I'm both. Exhibit A, Exhibit B, and, well, Exhibit C.
Wait, huh?
I told your grandfather that you needed to study for an exam. That's why he gave you the night off.
Oh, you're upset. You think I'm skipping out on my responsibilities on that.
Is there another reason I should be upset with you?
No, nothing. Dad, this is great. You should totally hang out with us. You love baseball. It'd be really fun.
Marina.
Well, I better get home, so I think I'm going to need that ride home after all. It was so sweet of you to offer to drive me home. I mean, it was sweet of you to have Shane drive the both of us.
Is that your convertible parked out front, Shane?
No, it's not.
Well, you're a lucky man because I gave it a big fat ticket.
Wait, you did what?
Don't tell me. Marina!
Okay, I can explain. Let me just grab my stuff, okay?
You know what? You're not grabbing anything. Actually, you're coming with me right now, and you can drop off Mara's dress tomorrow.
Bye, everyone. Bye, pretty car.
Marina!
I really hope I didn't cause any real trouble for Marina when I mentioned the car.
Unbelievable.
What's unbelievable?
You are. You're unbelievable. Nothing is ever enough for you.
Honey, he's right. You can't just find the drugs in his system. We gotta link it to Alexandra. We have to prove it. We have to find something in her possession.
Honey, what we have to do is go to the DA and build a case. If we don't do this right, there won't be any case at all.
You know what? She's right. You're right. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Yeah. The important thing is, you know, that we're both on the same page in this. I'm gonna go rest. But thank you again, Harley. Listen, look at him. You do both want the same thing. You both are on the same page.
He wants revenge. I want justice. The question is, what do you want?
You know what I want.
Oh, all what, talk about turning over a new leaf, huh? You're still completely incapable of doing something for the sheer virtue of the thing.
I'm just going to step over here and leave a little room for the lightning to strike. Darling, you are in absolutely no position to preach about virtue. You make your brother's life a living hell. You strip him of his dignity and his sanity. I just think he's coming back to return the favor. And who the hell am I to get in his way?
All right. That drug is wearing off, Edmund. It can make him completely unpredictable. Who knows what he's capable of doing now?
Well, if I were in his shoes, I knew exactly what to do.
And please don't mention shoes.
You're really scared, aren't you? Well, I can promise there won't be a single bump in the night at the gala for Richard. So let's see. You've RSVP'd. Your checkbook is RSVP'd. And I think you'll be making another sizable donation.
No, I'm going to stay in until my potentially homicidal brother is found. But I'll write you a check right now if you want.
Wouldn't you rather be in a public place with lots of people?
Well, you have a point. So I'll be there.
Good. So, what am I supposed to do with Alan when I find him?
Nothing. Nothing. I want to find him so I can help him. And it, so he won't get hurt. And so he won't be able to hurt me either. Well, I think that is what I'm paying your conscience to stay quiet about, isn't it?
Money's going to Richard's library. I promised Cassie I'd raise a certain amount of money. I wasn't able to do it. Now I can. She deserves for this evening to be a great success.
Oh, she does she? Well, gosh, I guess I should have known that all this change wasn't totally out of brotherly love, I guess. Richard's legacy also includes his widow?
It's past curfew. It's not like you, Tammy. Hi, Tammy. I'm assuming you're concentrating on your driving, and that's why you're not answering your telephone. I'm sure you're gonna be walking in the door any minute. Goodbye.
Man, at least my parents gave me a 10-minute grace period.
Look how you turned out.
Yeah.
When Jude's 17, you're gonna do the same thing to him.
Oh, no. See, Jude's gonna stay 1.5 for the rest of his life. He thinks I'm the greatest daddy in the world, and that is the way it's going to stay.
Oh. Tammy grows older and wiser from breakfast to dinner. Just can't stop it.
Really looking forward to this. I think it's wonderful that you're throwing a party in Richard's honor, Cassie. He touched so many people's lives. He was such a good man, and certainly what he gave to me. There's not a day that goes by that I don't feel gratitude. I'm sorry I managed to ruin your day again.
No.
You've got a knack for that.
No, I'm fine. I just, maybe you're the one person who'll understand.
Understand what?
That on the eve of celebrating Richard's life, I feel like I'm betraying him.
Sakes, I'm never gonna sleep. You know, oh, you know, Alan, you're always the one afraid of the dark, afraid of being locked in the closets, weren't you? Afraid of the monsters in there? Brandon was the monster you wanted because he's the one that locked you in the bloody closets, remember? I'm the one that always got you out, Alan.
Comfortable down here.
Down here?
Down here.
Anybody
if my father comes down, catches us on the couch or
something. Then it'll be like high school.
You know? You're making out?
Yeah.
Only my father wasn't around, so I never really had that experience. But Frank was sort of tough.
Some time to make up for fear.
Said the more therapy, the better.
Really? Well, does this qualify?
Yes.
Do you have any idea how amazing you are?
Get this straight. This is Edmund you're talking about? Edmund Winslow? Tall guy, looks good in a suit.
This is so embarrassing.
Why, don't be embarrassed. Cassie, come on. Look, look at this past. You've worked so hard to get your life back on track, and you've done that. But life is more than hanging on. It certainly wouldn't be a sin for you to start dating again. And God forbid, even be kissed again. Give yourself a break.
You think?
I know. I mean, even though it's Edmund,
I told Edmund that it could be any man. But I'm not so sure that's true.
Really?
He's the only person that doesn't look at me like poor Cassie, you know?
So, I mean, you know, if I didn't look at you that way, would, you know, you kiss me?
Get out of here! Hi, Rick.
Hey, how you doing,
Pam? Mom, I'm sorry. I know it's late. It'll never happen again.
Oh, it's okay.
I'm just so glad you're home and you're safe. Okay. Well, we're going to go to bed.
I got a meeting. Good seeing
you, Tammy. Talk.
You're welcome.
Wait, you're the violinist.
How'd you know?
I'm Edmund Winslow.
I know. I'm Sam.
Sam, of course you are. The waltz you were playing earlier. Would you mind playing it again, Sam?
This has been Guiding Light.